طريقي كي أراه يطيب طيب الحياة.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Content is something that Allah Azza wa Jal loves, and Allah Azza wa Jal love people who had this contempt with what Allah Azza wa Jal has provided them. And Allah Azza wa Jal prohibited people to ask others for money unless there is a real need for it. The asking itself is punishable. If people ask to just get extras, then they will be punished with hell in the hereafter. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, من سأل الناس تكثرا, whoever asks people to just get more and increase what he has, فإنما يسأل جمرا, then he is asking people to give him a lit charcoal, fire, pieces of fire. فليستقل أو ليستكثر, let him have either little or more. It's fire that he is going to get, and anything that that Allah has threatened with fire means that this thing is haram. So it is haram to ask without real necessity, and the more that he asks, the more punishments that he gets, and he would come even in the hereafter again with a face of bone, a skull with no flesh at all. And it will come also as scars. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إن المسألة كد يكد بها الرجل في وجهه. Asking people money are scars that will be accumulated in the face of a man. إلا أن يسأل الرجل الرجل سلطانا, unless he asking a prince, someone who, a leader, because he is in real need, and the baytul mal supposed to give that person a need through that person of authority. أو في أمر لا بد من, or a matter that he must ask for. So it is very ugly, the face of a person who would ask. المسألة كد يكد بها الرجل وجهه. It's a scar that happened in the face of a man unless he is asking for a real necessity. And this shows how much yaqeen and trust and certainty and reliance upon Allah Azza wa Jal when these calamities happen to us. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, من أصابته فاقه, whoever is hit by a calamity, فأنزلها بالناس, and he asked people for it, لم تسد فاقته, then Allah would not provide him to close that calamity that he has. ومن أنزلها بالله, and whoever asked Allah to close his calamity, فَيُوشِكُ اللَّهُ لَهُ بِرِزْقٍ عَاجَلٍ, then he is about to be provided by Allah with a very fast provision, أو آجل, or a later provision. Wahb ibn Munabbih said to a person who used to come to kings, he said, وَيْحَكْ, woe to you, تأتي من يغلق عنك بابه, you come to the one who closes his door against you, وتدع من يفتح لك بابه, and you leave the one who opens the door for you, meaning Allah Almighty. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says, من تكفل لي ألا يسأل الناس شيئا, whoever promise me not to ask people anything, وأتكفل له بالجنة, and I will grant for him paradise. The narrator, his name is Tawbah رضي الله عنه, said, فقلت أنا فكان لا يسأل أحدا شيئا, and then he said, I would do so, would not ask people, and he continued like this, never asking people for anything at all. One of the Sahaba, his name is Abu Bishr. There are two groups of people who had a dispute. And the way to fix that dispute is to give money for one of them. قال تحملت حمالة. I have given carried this mission, which is to get money to give money for one of these parties. فأتيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أسأله فيها. And then I came to صلى الله عليه وسلم asking him for money to solve this problem with. فقال أقم. He said stay with us حتى تأتينا الصدقة فنأمر لك بها. Until alms, donations, money come to us, and then we will command to give it to you. And then Abu Bashr, his first name is Qabisa. He said, Ya Qabisa, Inna al-mas'ala, O Qabisa, asking people money, La tahil, is haram, is not halal, illa li ahadi thalatha, except for three people. Rajulun tahammala hamala, a man who would carry a dispute to and collect money to solve this problem. فحلت له المسألة حتى يصيبها. And then it become halal and okay for him until he finished that matter. ثم يمسك. And then he withhold. ورجل أصابته جائحة. And then a man who was hit by a calamity. اجتاحت ماله. It took his provision of money. فحلت له المسألة حتى يصيب قواما من عيش. And then it was okay for him to ask until he had barely enough. أو قال سدادا من عيش or سدادا من عيش or something that would close his poverty. ورجل أصابته فاقة. And a man hit by poverty حتى يقول ثلاثة من ذوي الحجة until three people of intelligence, of mind, من قومه, of his people. لقد أصابت فلانا فاقة. This person has been hit with poverty. فحلت له المسألة. And then asking people is halal for him حتى يصيب قوام من عيش. قوام is what make you stand. You know, someone who is very who is very hungry would not stand and erect like and pause like all the other people. It says قواماً, something that will make him stand. And these words that come, فقير or مسكين, also comes from this word. الفقير in Arabic comes from the word فقار. فقار is the vertebrum, the bones of the backbone, vertebra. So these bones are not standing upon each other because he is very hungry. And that's why he's called فقير. Because his backbone can stand out of hunger. And that's why Rasulullah says, حَتَّى يُصِيبَ قَوَامًا أَوْ عَيْشًا. Also مِسْكِين. The word مِسْكِين comes from سَكَنَة. Because he is so hungry and he doesn't have enough, then he is tranquilized. A second is not to move a lot. So out of hunger, he is ساكن. ساكن meaning that he is still because of that hunger. All of this comes from the word of poverty. قال حتى يصيب قواما من عيش. Until he had enough, you know, he said if he is poor, then it's okay for him. Very, very poor, then it's okay for him to ask until he get enough to have a qawaman of aish, standing of a living, or sadadan min aish, or something that will close his poverty. فَمَا سِوَهُنَّ مِنَ الْمَسْأَلَةِ يَا قَبِيصَ سُحْت. So beyond that is haram. يَأْكُلُهَا صَاحِبُهَا سُحْتًا. He is eating a haram money. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه سيد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says ليس المسكين الذي يطوف على الناس. The مسكين, and we have explained the word مسكين from second, is very tranquilized because of hunger. That's the Arabic word مسكين. ليس المسكين الذي يطوف على الناس, the one who goes around people, ترده اللقمة واللقمتان, and he will be sufficed by one bite or two, والتمرة والتمرتان, or one piece of date or two, ولكن المسكين الذي لا يجد غنى يغنيه. The مسكين is the one who doesn't find something to suffice himself. ولا يفطن له فيتصدق عليه. And people wouldn't recognize him and they wouldn't give him. What is more than that? ولا يقوم فيسأل الناس. And he would not stand and then ask people. This is the مسكين. And this is the one that Allah spoke in the Quran by saying the donation should be given to this. للفقراء الذين أحصروا في سبيل الله, for the poor people who were being, you know, seized in the cause of Allah, and then Allah described them by saying يحسبهم الجاهل أغنياء من التعفف. People think that they are sufficient out of not asking people. تعرفهم بسيماهم, you can see from their faces, like Rasulullah ﷺ recognized one or two more than Sahaba, like Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه and the others, because they were very hungry and they can see. تعرفهم بسيماهم, you know them from their features and the way that they look. And this is what happened to Rasulullah ﷺ with Abu Hurairah in one more than one story, and also the people of the Suffa. Sometimes they will almost fainted, and those are the people that the للفقراء. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, "الصدقه." The donation should be given to للفقراء الذين أحصروا في سبيل الله لا يسألون الناس إلحافا. The only time it is halal to ask for people if you have poverty, and some of Sahaba did not take from Rasulullah sallam. Also, they had this, but they wanted to prefer others upon them. Umar radiallahu anhu said, you know, there is something called ata, which is the from the booties that the Sahaba used to give. It's like salaries that they get because of what they did with Rasulullah sallam, and they bring this from expeditions. قال عمر رضي الله عنه كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يعطيني العطاء. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم used to give me my salary. فأقول أعطه من هو أفقر إليه مني. Give it to a person who is poorer than me. فقال خذه, take it. إذا جاءك من هذا المال شيء وأنت غير مشرف ولا سائل. If the money comes to you and you are not looking for it and you are not asking, فخذه فتموله, and then take it and do whatever you want with it. This is your money. فإن شئت كله, if you want then eat it, وإن شئت تصدق به, and if you wish donate it. ولا تتبعه نفسك. And don't follow it with your soul. Don't look eager upon it. The narrator of the hadith is the son of Umar رضي الله عنه, عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنه, قال فكان عبد الله لا يسأل أحدا شيئا. After this, he never asked anybody anything, ولا يرد شيئا أعطيه, and he never said no to something that he is being given. So if you are being given your salary, your money, somebody is giving you something, then this is completely fine. And if you take it, don't give it back. If you wish, just take it. And then if you want to give from your salary, from the money that comes to you, then it's up to you. And Allah Azza wa Jalla praised those people who, when they have their salaries or income, they would give the others rather than bringing it back. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقُّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. And in their money, there is a right for the bequester and the deprived person. So it's completely fine if you are giving without asking at all. And it's also better to get your provision of money by working. You should work yourself. Allah Azza wa Jal has commanded people to work and to do business in order to get money rather than asking people and begging. For example, Allah Azza wa Jal in Surah Al-Jumu'ah, Allah Azza wa Jal says in Ayah 10, فَإِذَا قُضِيَتِ الصَّلَاةِ, and when you finish the prayers, فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ, then spread on the earth, وَابْتَعُوا مِنْ فَضْلِ اللَّهِ, and then ask from the bounties of Allah. So Allah Azza wa Jal had made transaction, buying, selling, working as a halal. وأحل الله البيع. Allah says عراك بن مالك after صلاة الجمعة he would stand on the door of the masjid. This ayah, فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله, it is in Surah Al-Jum'ah. So Allah Azza wa Jalla was speaking about Surah Al-Jum'ah. So he would stand in front of the door of masjid, and then he would say, Allahumma inni ajabtu da'watak, O Allah, I respond to your call by coming to the masjid, by coming when you call me to the, wa sallaytu faridatak, and I prayed the obligationary salah, which is Jum'ah, wa intashartu kama amartani, and then I spread on the earth as you had promise me, فَارْزُقْنِي مِنْ فَضْلِكَ وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّازِقِينَ, so provide me from your bounty and you are the best provider. That was the advice of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim, who had been tested by poverty and decrease in provision, but he said it's way better to work rather than asking people. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم أني أخذ أحدكم حبلة, it's better for one of you to take a rope, أني أخذ أحبله, his ropes, ثم يأتي الجبل, and then he would go to the mountain, فيأتي بحزمة من حطب, and then he would come with a pile of wood على ظهره, on his back, فيبيعها, and then he would sell this logs and wood, فَيَكُفُّ اللَّهُ بِهَا وَجْهَ, and Allah will suffice him, that he will protect her face, خَيْرٌ لَهُ مِنْ أَنْ يَسْأَلَ النَّاسِ, better for him than asking people, أَعْطَوهُ أَوْ مَنَعُوهُ, they either would give him or prevent him. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, يَحْتَطِبُ أَحَدُكُمْ حُزْمَةً عَلَى ظَهْرِي خَيْرٌ لَهُ مِنْ يَسْأَلَ أَحَدًا فَيُعْطِيهِ أَوْ يَمْنَعَهِ, لَأِي يَحْتَطِبَ أَحَدُكُمْ حُزْمَةٌ عَلَى ظَهْرِي, it's better for you, sat, with that someone will come and log woods and put that wood on his back, better for him than asking one person who would either give him or prevent him. And Rasulullah said about one of the great prophets and messengers of Allah, Dawood alayhi salam, he said, كان داود عليه السلام لا يأكل إلا من عمل يديه. داود عليه السلام never have eaten anything but from the craft of his hand. وكان داود عليه السلام ملك النبي. داود, he was a king and he was a prophet. وكان ينسج الدروع ويبيعها. Although he is a king and a prophet, he used to weave arsens and sell it. ولا يأكل إلا من ثمنها, and he does not eat but from the revenues of selling arsons, shields. Also another messenger was a carpenter. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كان زكريا عليه السلام نجارا. علي زكريا عليه السلام was a carpenter. So look at those prophets and messengers. Zakaria alayhi salam was a carpenter. Dawud alayhi salam was a shield crafter. Rasul alayhi salam was a shepherd. And the majority of the Sahaba, as a matter of fact, all the prophets and messengers used to be work as shepherd. ما بالنبي إلا وقد رعى الغنم. There's no prophet, but he had been a shepherd, taking care of sheep. He said, even me, كنت أرعاها لأهل مكة على قراريط. I used to take care of sheep of the people of Mecca for little money. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم ما كان أحد ما أكل أحد طعاما خير قط خير من أن يأكل من عمل يده. Best food that you eat is from the work of your hand. وإن نبي الله داود عليه السلام كان يأكل من عمل يده. He used to داود eat from the work of his hand. When Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "This is the best type of earnings," he was asked, "أي الكسب أطيب أو أفضل?" What is the best type of earnings? He said, "عمل الرجل عمل الرجل بيده وكل بيع مبرور." He said, "The best type of income that comes from the handwork or from any buying and selling, then it is blessed." May Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala bless us all in our provisions. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
الهداية والتقى وللطريق كي أراه يطيب الحياة بحبنا للدعوة لله رب العالمين تطيب أسعد قلوبا بالهداية والتقى وللطريق كي أراه يطيب طيب الحياة بحبنا للدعوة لله رب العالمين تطيب أسعد قلوبا بالهداية والتقى وعن الطريق كي أراه يطيب وعن الطريق كي أراه يطيب